So in our next question, it is given that in the triangle ABC, BD bisects angle B. So the given thing is BD bisects angle B. So if you are a follower of the previous videos, you will be able to analyze that we cannot write in a statement form. When we are proving or solving mathematical question, we should write in mathematical form. How to write in mathematical form? Bisects means dividing a thing into two equal parts. BD bisects angle B, that means BD is bisecting angle B. So there's a line BD, I'm not extending. So that means this angle has been divided into two parts, and those two parts are equal. So I can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Another thing which is given over there is BD is bisector of angle B and is perpendicular to AC. So they are also saying BD is perpendicular to AC. That means BD is perpendicular means 90 degree. So angle D equals to 90 degree. So these are the two mathematical ways we should represent, so that we can use the information for proving or solving the question. If the length of the sides of the given in terms of x, I'm writing them 3x plus 1, it is given 5y plus, sorry, minus 2, and here it is x plus 1 and y plus 2. We need to find the values of x. So before jumping onto the values of x, we should congruent them. So to find x and y, the question is easy, but solution is also easy. So first of all, we should write to find, find solution, not proof. We are not proving, we are finding. So solution, first of all, we congruent these two in triangle BDA and triangle BDC. If you don't know congruency, watch previous videos. First thing is 90 degrees given angle BDA. BDA equals to angle BDC, each equals to 90 degree. It is already given. Second thing is given, angle 1 equals to angle 2, angle 1 equals to angle 2, which is also given. Third thing is BD equals to BD, which is common. I am running through this thing because we have already discussed this thing many a time. So watch previous videos if you want to understand in detail how to do congruency. Now, the which property? Angle, side, angle. Therefore, triangle BDA is congruent to triangle BDC by angle, side, angle congruency criteria. So I can say AB is equals to BC. AB is equal to BC by CP CT. So therefore I can say 3x plus 1 is equal to 5y minus 2. So we have an equation 3x minus 5y equals to minus 2 minus 1. So 3x minus 5y equals to minus 3. This is our first equation. Similarly, I can say AD equals to DC, again by CP CTC. So what is AD? AD is x plus 1 and DC is what? Y plus 2. We got one more equation, x minus y equals to 2 minus 1. So x minus y equals to 1. So if you know this simultaneous linear equation, You can solve it very easily. I'll just quickly show you how to do it by elimination method. So just write both the equations. Just like this. Now we need to make one variable same, either x or y. So I'm multiplying this equation by 3 and this by 1. So I get 3x minus 5y equals to minus 3, and this equation by 3x, 3. So subtracting, this has positive, so it becomes negative. This is negative, it becomes positive. It is positive, it becomes negative. So 3x minus 3x, 0, minus 5y plus 3y is minus 2y. Minus 2y is equals to minus 3. Minus 3 is minus 6. And we got y equals to minus 6 over minus 2, that is 3. So y is equals to 3. We got the value of y. I can substitute in one equation or two equations. So as you can see, second equation is a bit easy. So I'm putting it 2. Putting in 2. So x minus 3 equals to 1, x equals to 1 plus 3, x equals to 4. So therefore we got both the values of x and y. If you don't understand this part, I would suggest watch the videos related to simultaneous linear equation. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.